अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम हुमेरा ताहिर एंड इट इज योर इंग्लिश क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 5 डैफोडिल्स। प्रीवियसली वी कंप्लीटेड द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पोएम एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द एक्सरसाइजेस। सो यू नीड टू ओपन योर बुक्स। Exercise number 1. Answer the following questions. Look at the first question. What is the central idea of the poem? The central idea of the poem is that the beautiful scenes of nature have an everlasting impact on the mind and soul of the human beings. In other words, we can say that a thing of beauty is a joy forever. So in this poem, poet has fantastically shown that the beautiful scenes of nature have an everlasting impression on the human mind. And whenever a person recalls those scenes, provides him the pleasure and happiness forever. Right? Now come to the next question. What do the daffodils represent in the poem? Daffodils in the poem represents nature, and it symbolizes the beginning of the spring, and it stands for nature and its balming, soothing, and everlasting impact on human mind and soul. Next question. What wealth do the memories of the scene give to the poet? The scene of daffodils brought to the poet an everlasting impression, and it was a source of happiness for the poet. So he says that that scene, when he recalled in his mind, that scene brings a kind of happiness, and he says that that happiness was like a wealth for him. And it was when he recollected the scene, his imagination stirred up and he felt delighted. Okay, next. List the words that heighten the sound effects in the poem. Now, sound effects are, number one, alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of consonant sounds. So you can see in the first stanza, beside the lake, beneath the trees. Here, the B sound is repeated. So it is an example of alliteration. In the last stanza, there is a line and dances with the daffodils. So D sound is repeating. It is also an example of alliteration. Now next, the other example of sound effect is assonance. When the vowel sounds are repeating, that is the example of assonance. So here the fluttering and dancing in the breeze. In, fluttering, dancing, in. So three times E sound is repeating, that is a vowel sound. So it is example of assonance. Which is the bliss of solitude? Which is bliss and solitude? E sound is again repeating. So it is the example of assonance. Okay. Now come to the next page. Here, the figures of speech are given, which are used in the poem. The first figure of speech is simile, as we have seen in the first stanza, first line, and the second stanza, the first line. The example of simile was given. Yes, just like in the first stanza, the poet says, "I wandered lonely as a cloud." So he is comparing himself with the cloud, using as. and in the second stanza continuous as the stars that shine. So again, as is used for the comparison, so it is an example of simile. Simile is a figure of speech in which like or as is used to make a comparison between two ideas that are basically dissimilar. Examples are given here. Her eyes twinkled like the stars, like the stars. She was as busy as a bee. So here, like and as is used for comparison. These are the examples of simile. Now next is metaphor. Metaphor is the comparison between two things when we omit the word like or as, or it is the direct comparison of apparently different but inwardly similar things. Examples: he proved a lion in the fight, his heart is red, red rose, he has a heart of lion, or you can say that he was the tiger of the match. So here the examples are of the metaphor where the direct comparison is made. Next is personification. It is a figure of speech, or it is a technique where an object or idea is given a human characteristic or a human quality. For example, the candle flame danced in the dark. Now dancing is the human quality. Candle flame is moving like it was dancing. So here the personification is used. The sunflowers nodded in the wind. Nodded means moving the heads. So the flowers were moving in the breeze. So it was like nodding the heads. So these are the examples of personification when you gave the human quality to non-human things. Next is imagery. Imagery is the construction of details used to create mental images in the mind of the reader, or to make the writing colorful and impressive. There are five kinds of imageries: visual imagery, auditory imagery, smell imagery, taste imagery, and touch. According to five senses, there are different kinds of imagery, and it is the construction of details through words. Okay, now come to the next. Figures of speech used in the poem. When all at once I saw a crowd. Now crowd is compared with the number of daffodils. The number of daffodils, they were large in number. So as in a crowd, there are so many people. So the daffodils are compared with the crowd here. So it's an example of metaphor. Next is fluttering and dancing in the breeze. Personification, fluttering and dancing, giving human quality to the daffodils. Next, continuous as the stars that shine, as the star, comparing the stars with the daffodils. It's an example of what? Yes, simile. Next, distressed in never ending line. There must be some end of the daffodils, but here the poet is exaggerating, saying that it had no end. So he is using hyperbole, exaggerating the fact. Come to the next exercise. Time is money. A list is given below. You have to mark that whether it is an example of simile, metaphor, or personification. Number one. That is, time is money. Look here, time is money. What example is this? It is an example of metaphor, yes. As money is valuable, so time is also valuable. So time is related to money. Both have the common quality, that is value. So it is an example of metaphor. Next is as busy as a bee. Comparison between bee and a person who is so busy. So he is being compared with bee. So it in using as. So comparison using as is called simile. Next one. The wind whispered the rumors of the forest. Whispered. Whispered is human quality, so it is personification. As gentle as a lamb, family. The sorry engine wheezed its death cup, its personification. The heart of the loin, metaphor. The apple of my eye, this is also metaphor. As cunning as a fox, family. Brown grass was begging for water. What is this? Yes, begging. Human quality being given to the grass, that is personification. As wise as an owl. What is this? Simile. Blanket of snow. Yes. As blanket covers everything, so snow also covers everything. So it is an example of metaphor. As black as a crow. Yes. Comparison between black color and the crow. This is the example of simile. Understand? Now come to the next. Connotation. Now connotation is a feeling associated with a word. Sometimes a word has a positive, gives us a positive feeling, and sometimes it gives us a negative feeling. So look here. Example is given. Solitude. Solitude means alone. Lonely means also alone. But solitude gives us positive feeling and lonely gives us negative feeling. So similarly, you have to find out what connotation is given in these words. Gaze. Gaze is positive connotation. Look fixedly. Stare means, it also means look fixedly, but it gives us negative connotation. Shine. Shine is positive connotation and glare is negative connotation. Hoard. Hoard means to stock something, negative connotation, and to collect. Collect means to gather something, so it is positive connotation. Come to the next. Kinds of nouns. There are different kinds of nouns. For example, common noun, proper noun, material noun, collective noun, abstract noun. So, but here we are only concerned with collective noun. A collective noun refers to a group of people, animals, or things. For example, class, committee, team. These are the examples of collective noun which represent the group of some kind or some person or animal. Now here, crowd in the poem, crowd in this poem refers to the collection or large number of daffodils. So crowd is here collective noun. Write the collective nouns of the following words. Okay, a collection of ships. Give a collective noun for this. Collection of ships is called a fleet. F-L-E-E-T, fleet. Collection of cattle, herd, H-E-R-D, herd. Collection of singers. Yes, band, B-A-N-D, band. Collection of soldiers, army, A-R-M-Y, army. See exercise, use the following prepositions in the sentence of your own. Now these are all preposition of place, behind, beside, next, to, under, over, along, and across. Behind means piche, beside means ke saath, next to, se agla. Under, niche, over, upar, along, saath, across, ke paar. So you need to make sentences of these prepositions, and these are all prepositions which are used in the poem. So you need to make sentences of your own using the preposition of place. Right? Come on. Next is conjunctions. Conjunctions are the joining words which are used in compound sentences. There are two kinds of conjunctions. Linking words or joining words are of two types. Number one is coordinating conjunction and number two is subordinating conjunctions. Coordinating conjunctions join the sentences of equal ranks. In other words, we can say that they join the independent clauses. while subordinate in conjunctions, they join independent as well as dependent clauses. One of which is dependent and the other can be independent. Look at the examples of coordinating conjunctions. These are the words that join to make a compound sentence that are used for joining. But, or, nor, either, also, however, only, so, and hence. And subordinating conjunctions, because, that, while, unless, as, when, since, if, and thou. Now you can use these type of conjunctions in the blanks given in the next exercise. He ran fast, but he missed the train. He ran fast, but he missed the train. What type of conjunction is this? But, yes, coordinating. Wait till I return. Wait till I return. Next, work hard, otherwise you should fail, or work hard lest you should fail. I did not come because you did not invite me. I did not come because you did not invite me. Next, you will get a prize if you deserve it. You will get a prize if you deserve it, or you can also put as you deserve it. You will get a prize as you deserve it. Both are correct. Okay. Now these are the exercises we have done today, and you have to prepare them for your objective paper. Also learn the question answers and objective exercises of the chapter 5, Daffodils. Now it is done. Get yourself ready for your test. Okay. Allah Hafiz.